I would have never expected.
Hey, ladies and gentlemen, thank you so much for being here. Before we get all my introductory remarks in, our Band Parent Association has graciously put together a few gift baskets that I'm assuming all of you have some type of ticket for. So before we do get started, the band parents are just gonna do a quick drawing of some of our raffle baskets. And this is basket number one. It looks like a Starbucks container. My niece would love it. The winner is ticket number 9177387. 9177387. Anybody? Oh, I see a hand raise. Come on down. Is that Kathy? That's Mrs. DeVita. Oh. Basket number two. And this looks like a great picnic basket. This coupon code is 9177363. Okay, I feel like it was. Last three numbers are 363-9177-363. Anybody? Oh, oh, come on down! You're the next contestant on Price is Right. How are you, Miss Hager? How's Rutgers? Good. Freshman or sophomore? Sophomore, but you're wearing College Park stuff. Okay. All right, cool. Here you go. And this is basket number three. Longhorn Steakhouse, 9177350. 350. 9177? 350. Up, 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 up. I see a hand. 350. That's Mrs. Pond, everybody. Give a round of applause. Thank you so much. This is basket number 4. Good housekeeping kitchen. I was going to say, yeah, Pampered Chef. I know Pampered Chef very well. This is a Pampered Chef gift basket. 9177549. 549. Oh, I see a hand. Yay! Congratulations, Ms. Coleman. And the last one, I believe, is a 50-50. This 186 to the winner. Thank you so much, ladies and gentlemen, for all your donations tonight. Very, very much so appreciated tonight. And the winner, I'm so glad I'm not grabbing these tickets. I did that once and it was terrible. I felt so bad for all, you know, people who didn't get one. Anyway, this is 7241780. 724-1780. Anybody? 724-1780. Going once. Going twice. All right, we're going to pick another one. All right, here we go. Once again, new number 724-1315. 1315. 724-1315. Thank you. Thank you so much, and congratulations to all our people. Now that we're doing that, I just want to introduce myself. My name is Jason Diaz. I am the director of bands here at Jackson Memorial High School. Thank you so much for being here tonight and coming to celebrate music at Jackson Memorial High School. I just want to do a real quick overview of some things, announcement, and get them all away out of the way at the beginning. It's kind of how I start every class anyway. The first thing, I want you to give a round of applause to the Jazz Lab Band who was just out in the hallway. They did fantastic. Give them one more round of applause. I'm super excited this year because we are back in full force. Last year we were about 80%, and now that we've had a full school year, you are going to hear between the hours of 6:45 and hopefully before 9 o'clock, you are gonna hear 6 different ensembles tonight. And as I thought about it and I was writing down my notes for this afternoon, our band room, our percussion room, and all of our other practice rooms around this area, after school, from Monday through Thursday, there is somebody in that space. After school, not during the school day, not when we do the concert band, symphonic band, all of these additional small ensembles are out there. Can you give these kids a real big round of applause for really sticking to this program? I do want to take a few seconds and I do want to acknowledge a few people. The first person I do want to acknowledge is our counterpart in the chorus department. Mr. Robertson is a fantastic resource. When we do our Spring Pops concert, we get together the chorus and the band, and it's really, really nice to have a great collaborator out there just to kind of brainstorm some things, so I just want to acknowledge him. Mr. McCarthy, I know, is in the audience. I saw him earlier. He's somewhere around here. There he is. Thank you. Mr. McCarthy had a fantastic concert Tuesday night here with the guest department. So thank you so much for being here tonight. I know in the program, you've probably seen an unfamiliar name in my thanks program. Ross Hecht is the band director at Allentown High School, and he has been a huge resource for us this year. A lot of our concert band symphonic music came from his library and Mr. McCarthy's library, and he was really cool about it and just said, here, you can borrow whatever you want. So I just want to acknowledge Mr. Hecht, and just so you understand why his name is in the program. The other person I do want to recognize, and I'm going to say it just in about 15 minutes, one of our Memorial alumni actually came back and is playing piano with us. I just want to give a round of applause and a shout out to Sam Russo, wherever you are. So thank you so much for being here, Sam. As always, I do want to acknowledge and truly, truly do acknowledge our building and district administrators. Mr. DiEugenio is in the back corner right now. We really couldn't do anything that we do here, and it's a very much so comfort for our department that they trust in us And when I come up with these kooky ideas, like, hey, we're gonna bring in 6 bands and we're gonna do a fundraiser during the school day, and he wholeheartedly supported everything that we do here. Same thing from upper administration, Mrs. Pramilli and such. Can you give all of our administrators, Board of Education, a round of applause, please? And in addition to that, we have a fantastic technology department here. I know I say it before every single concert, but I really truly do really mean it. There are 2 cameras in the back there. We have all of these video monitors. We're also gonna have rear projection things. And Mr. Noble is fantastic. When I say 2 days ago, hey, can you put together slides so we can have all of our names and blah, 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 and all that stuff? And his answer is always, sure, I'll see what I can do. This is from Mr. Noble, so I'm going to read. JTV will be shooting tonight's concert and selling DVDs to take home with you right after the show ends. DVDs will be sold for $15 and ready about 15 minutes after the conclusion of the concert at the table just outside the auditorium. New this year, all DVD purchases now include a digital copy you can download and keep forever. The concert will also be streaming live tonight on JTV's YouTube channel, so people that couldn't make it can go right now to www.jtvlive.org. Once again, that's www.jtvlive.org, so you can text that out to all your friends and family so they can see tonight's concert. Or if they live here in Jackson, they can go to Cablevision Channel 77 in Jackson. Can you give all of our technology department a big round of applause for being here? Thank you. All right, guys, I'm almost done. Last thing I just want to remember, if you turn your attention to the back of the program down on the bottom where you see the JAG head, I just want to remind you really quickly about cell phones. Just make sure your cell phones are silent. These kids have worked really hard. I talked to you about Thursday, Monday through Thursday after school, and they are here during fourth period for an hour and a half every day. They work really, really hard, and we do push them to their limits, to their musical limits, and we really do truly hope you do that. Just check your cell phone, make sure it's off, right, and really just enjoy the music and all of their enthusiasm for what we do. And lastly, I just want to introduce our Woodwind Choir, Mrs. Fodor, under the direction of Mrs. Fodor, and they're going to do a fantastic job. Can you give them a round of applause and welcome them to the stage?
Good evening. Hi, everyone. My name is Rebecca Fodor, and I'm the director of the Woodwind Choir. We have 2 pieces for you tonight. The first piece is Irish Tune from County Derry, and the second piece is Gypsy Rondo. But before we play those pieces, I'd like to introduce Bloom Swindell on clarinet and Gracie Sawicki on bass clarinet. They're going to play for us a piece called Danse Espanol by Ramon Acquabella. And just a little aside, we've been performing this piece rehearsing this piece for a while, and the girls actually brought it to the Ocean County Teen Arts Festival in March and performed it there, and they were awarded an Outstanding Achievement Award, and from there they're going to be performing at the State Teen Arts Festival at Middlesex County College in June. So, you know, a great achievement for the girls. Please give them a round of applause. Without further ado, here is Danse Espanol. Thank you.
Thank you. last band.
You know what? I wanted to do a bit of a warm up story.
When is Family Guy anymore?
Anyway, hi, ladies and gentlemen, thank you so much. One more round of applause for our School Woodwind Choir. Irish tune from County Derry. It is a gorgeous work, and that arrangement is fantastic. They really treated it very well, so I just want to compliment all the Woodwind Choirs. It was very well done. That's the first time I heard it, so kudos to all of you. In front of you is our jazz ensemble. Very fortunate for us, this is our third performance in this auditorium here. Usually going into the spring concert, especially when they play in the Pops concert, we usually kind of take a little bit of a back seat with this ensemble, and we try to feature some of the other ensembles, and that's really what my plan was. The members of the ensemble just kept nagging me about this one particular piece. They're like, can we play Magic League? I'm like, no, it's too hard. No, we're not going to have enough time. Finally, I gave in. I said, you know what? I'm going to pull it out. We're going to play it, and it's not going to sound good. You know what? Then we'll just put it away, and we'll do it. So, lo and behold, they went and played it, and I'm like, I think we're going to do it, because it sight read so well. It's been a real joy to revisit this piece. We did this piece about 7 years ago, and it's been just a real nice revisit to come back to it. So this is Sammy Nestico's version of Magic Flea. This was actually made famous by the Count Basie Band. And once again, this is going to feature Sam Russo, who I mentioned earlier. Again, came back in. One more round of applause. Thank you, Sam, for being here. And also Nate Tolan on the tenor saxophone. So we hope you enjoy. Thank you. I'd be remiss if I didn't mention Anthony had a drum solo and right at the end. Give him a round of applause one more time. A little behind the scenes on that. Once we got out of the Pops concert, this ensemble has kind of met sporadically. I'm super impressed. That is I'm going to call it a big boy chart. I'm going to put it in quotation marks. But they did that in, I'm going to say, 8 or 9 rehearsals. It's absolutely insane. I really didn't think they were going to do it. And they played their butts off. So congratulations to all of you. But yeah, please. One of my perennial favorites to do with this ensemble is a chart called Birdland. I thought I had done it recently. I went to Sam and said, Sam, haven't you played this with me before? And he was like, no. So it's been at least 4 years since I've done this. This is a fantastic arrangement of a very, very standard chart. This is Birdland. We hope you enjoy. Oh, this is going to feature Matt, Darren, and Jameson. So we hope you enjoy.
I guess we're on a first name basis.
Thank you. begin transmission. We have a few people who are not percussionists full-time in here. If you could raise your hand, please. You can see we have different color shirts and all kinds of stuff. We got people running all over the place trying to get as many musical opportunities as they can. So this is kind of one of our ways to do that. So if you just give me a second to get myself situated, we are ready to go. After we are done with this piece, we're going to move into something that is going to feel very unique and very different. And I hope you enjoy it. We're not going to talk in between. It's just going to go right in. So just get ready and strap in. It's going to be a really cool thing. So begin transmission. So these are actually two pieces that I've been waiting. These were initially programmed for the year where we had to shut everything down for COVID, and I've been waiting to bring them back in. We finally have the groups to play them. This one is a super special piece. You'll see, Lena, if you don't mind holding one of those up, right, or both of those up. If you notice, that's not a usual percussion implement, right? If you notice, that's probably from a string family instrument. We can use those on the instrument you have here. It's called the vibraphone, right? It's a really, really awesome sound, and the whole piece is based off of this. I really hope you enjoyed this. It's a really awesome piece, and they're doing a great job with it. So.
Thank you.
right, so there's going to be a little bit of a switch that happens behind me, so I'll fill some time, right? It's pretty cool, right? Right, seeing a couple of, first of all, seeing multiple people playing the same instrument is a little strange, right? And maybe you might share the instrument with one other person, but to have four, right? And if you didn't notice, there's actually people who are standing on the opposite side. So as I introduced this piece to them, they looked at me because they had to learn how to figure out where the notes were upside down on the instrument. So that was a fun figure out to get there, right? Then we had to get all the bows in a certain spot, right? Figure out where that is. Katie Noble is in the building somewhere, I think. Yep, Katie is raising her hand. Thank you so much. We actually are borrowing Katie's instrument for this because she has a really wonderful brand new sounding vibraphone for this. So it really kind of led itself to the piece really well. So thank you, Katie, for that really great. So again, that piece is something that I was really looking forward to doing in the year of 2020, and then we just didn't get a chance to do it for very obvious reasons, and now we were able to get it back. This next piece is the same thing. This piece called Luminescence. It's a big, what we call percussion orchestra piece, where you're gonna see there's a lot of instruments moving behind me. There's a lot of the big kind of setup with everything. You get all the different instruments. If you think these are all called xylophones, they all have their own individual names. We have ones that are, there is a xylophone, but then you heard we have the vibraphone, which is our metal version. We have the marimba, which is our larger wooden version, right? We've got chimes up there that kind of sound like church bells, and all the other different types of instruments that are back here. You're going to hear a little bit of everything in this piece. It kind of encompasses every aspect of what we do in the percussion section, and this is a pretty challenging piece. It took us a good amount of time to put this together, a lot of effort individually, and you're really going to see how much hard work they put into this. So as we finish getting this set up, once we are ready to go, we will get started, and I hope you enjoy.
Thank you.
so we can get all this stuff to the back of the stage and we can reset the chairs and start our concert band portion of the evening, that would be great. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Tempo, yes? Right tempo, play the right notes, communicate. That's it. That's all you guys gotta do. Yeah? Thank you. Thank you so much, ladies and gentlemen. In front of you is the Memorial Concert Band. This is an ensemble comprised of freshmen and sophomore students. This is an ensemble where we get an opportunity to really, really dive into the fundamentals and really just hone in on all the skills that they started to learn in middle school and just making sure that they are playing the correct time. These are our big concepts this season, is playing in time, playing the correct notes, and communicating with the conductor. That's three things. And communicating with the conductor. And that was really a culmination of all three of those concepts. That was a piece called Comedian's Gallop. Give them one more round of applause, please. We're going to slow things down a little bit with a fantastic Frank Erickson composition entitled Legendary Air. Please enjoy. Me upstairs. Thank you so much, ladies and gentlemen, once again. We're going to conclude the concert band portion of this concert with a composition entitled Shackleford Banks. As I was reading the program notes on this, this is actually what we would consider a programmatic work. The composer, Jay Bocook, had read an article
about an island off the coast of, I believe it was Georgia, and they had these wild horses around that area, similar to, I know there's an area up in Delaware, I can't remember the name of the horses, but it's something similar to that. Somebody said it? There you go. Thank you so much for whomever that was. But and this island with the wild horses on it, they I think the state of Georgia was going to kind of overrun all the wild horses and create, you know, project areas and stuff like that. And the community actually rallied around the wild horses and really just saved them and made sure that they were still wild horses and really preserved that area. So Mr. Bocook created a piece based on that. So we hope you do enjoy Mr. Bocook's arrangement of Shackleford Banks.
Second, we're going to flip over from concert band to symphonic band. Thank you so much, everybody.
show. They'll be ready 10 to 15 minutes after, and people will line up.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, can you please welcome the symphonic band to the stage? Give them a round of applause. This is our upperclassmen ensemble, and I think I said this during the Pops concert, that this ensemble just continues to impress me, and we just keep putting music in front of them that is just, it's high-level high school literature, if not collegiate literature, and they just keep ravaging it and saying, yes, we want more. They're up for the challenge. So it has been a real treat for both Mr. Ficarra and I to work with this ensemble. So we hope you do enjoy this portion of the program. This first piece that we're going to be doing is entitled A Journal for a Soldier. I've actually had this in my library for a few years, and I've been waiting to pull it out, and I just... enamored that we had the opportunity to do it with this ensemble. I was talking with the concert band about programmatic works, pieces that tell a story, and this piece in particular does tell a specific story. And I'm just going to relay and summarize what the composer had said about this piece. Mr. Balmages was on an airplane, and he was probably going to another conducting gig or something like that. He got on the plane, and the flight attendant had did an all call and said, "Hey, I have this journal. I met a soldier that was overseas right now and serving our country, and the best thing that I can do to him to support him was put a book together. And if you can do me a favor, if you could just pass it around, read the book, sign the book, whatever you want, just so that the soldier knows that we are supporting." So it passed down, some people wrote in the book, and it came to Mr. Balmages, and he was flipping through it and reading it, and one of the lines or the pages was in it said this: "My daddy is in the army. Sometimes I miss him, but I know he's okay. I hope you come home soon. God bless you. Lauren, age 8. And that really inspired him. He had 2 young children at the time, and it really, really stuck with him that an 8-year-old really understood the ways of the world. And he composed this beautiful work, again, called Journal for a Soldier. And he quotes 2 different well-known compositions. The first one is Brahms' Lullaby, Go to Sleep. And a famous famous hymn called Eternal Father, Strong to Save. So we hope you enjoy Brian Balmages' Journal for a Soldier.
Thank you.
Hello again. So up next, we have a monumental work for the wind band. This is the Gustav Holst's second suite in F major for military band. This is one of the most well-known pieces of music that you will have for this group of musicians. It wasn't always that we had a wind band. It wasn't always that we had a wind band of this instrumentation. This was one of the first pieces that was written for this group of people specifically, or this type of group of people. And that has become kind of the standard of what we know as a concert band, especially if you've come to many of our concerts, you see we have the same group of people that are around on the same type of instruments and all that. It's one of those kind of works where everything was based off of that. And just like Mr. Diaz said, this is one of those things where we have been waiting for a group that could actually pull this piece off. And as we kind of kept putting this together, it just kept getting better and better and better. And it's one of anybody who knows anything about wind band loves this work, all of us included. So I hope you enjoy it. There's four movements to this piece. They're all very different, but related to each other. And you're really going to get a nice treat when you listen to this. So this is the Gustav Holst Second Suite for band. Thank you. Well, we have one more stage shift to do to bring the entire ensemble together. So if you just give us a few seconds to do that. But one more time for that. Isn't that an amazing piece of music? Any soloists in that, if you could stand, please? Any soloists in that piece, could you stand? We have Jameson for trumpet. Soloists, if you could stand up, please. Bloom, are you euphoniums? Tuba. Great work. Thank you so much.
Night, and we really appreciate you supporting this ensemble and this department and just really working through all of our changes. Before we do the last number, I just want to go through a few other things that are in on the top of my mind. When I did my initial introduction and my thank yous and my acknowledgments, I am so sorry. I forgot to acknowledge the Band Parent Association. That raffle and the 50-50 and all the stuff outside on the table and anything that you see that's involved with the Memorial Band Program, the band parents have a hand in that. Can you give them a huge round of applause, please? If you are a current parent or an incoming parent, please make sure you get involved with this department and this program. It is fantastic. They are lifelong friends. There are band parent meetings the second Tuesday of every single month. And please, we're starting up the new season. We need all hands on deck, so please make sure you do that. I did not acknowledge during the symphonic band portion, we do have a super senior inside the ensemble. I do want to thank Mrs. Fodor for sitting in with the clarinet section. Can you stand up and be recognized, Mrs. Fodor, please? Going on the second suite thing, she found out that we were playing the second suite, and I did the same thing because I played as well. Second suite is just, it's kind of very near and dear to many band directors' hearts. We've played it a million times. It is a fantastic composition. So when she found out that we were playing it, she's like, can I play? I'm like, absolutely you can play, because I played as well. So thank you so much for that. I do want to acknowledge Mr. Vaccaro. I don't know if he's still here. Wherever there he is, Mr. Hey! I say this every single time, and I truly, truly do mean it. This program does not survive without Mr. Vaccaro being here. He is my much, much, much better half, and I just want to recognize that today is the last day of his school year. So he is going on paternity leave starting tomorrow, and he is sorely, sorely going to be missed at the end of the school year. So we hope you enjoy your paternity leave, enjoy the summer months, and enjoy that little guy, man. He is such a cutie. Can you give him a round of applause one more time? Lastly, but certainly not least, I would like to acknowledge the lifeblood in this ensemble. They have been here for 4 years. They started in a very normal school year in this department, and they were all wide-eyed and like, oh my God, what did I get myself into? And we got to March, and COVID hit. And it was a whirlwind 2.5 years, and we could not do that, get through. Was it their freshman year? Was it your freshman year? Yeah, it was, wasn't it? Yeah, I thought so. Okay. And we could not do anything without them. So seniors, if you wouldn't mind, can you please be standing recognized as the class of 2023 in our department, please? During the band bank, but it has been a pleasure working with them, and they most certainly keep me on my toes. They take me to task when I do something oopsies, and they don't have any problems calling me out on it. So I really appreciate you keeping me humble and keeping me grounded, so I very much so appreciate that to a degree. But in any event, once again, I really appreciate everything you've done to make this program the way it is, so congratulations to all of you. Okay? You guys can sit down now. Okay, and we're gonna finish our program with a combined number. This is a piece called Pacifica. It's a great piece. I found out, I think from the juniors, right, juniors? They got about halfway. Was it the juniors who got halfway? It was the senior class. More senior class. They actually did this with Mr. McCarthy, and for a number of reasons, did not get a chance to perform it in a concert. So I pulled it out, and they're like, oh my God, we've seen this before. So it's a really nice kind of capstone for everything that they've done in the music department, grade 8 all the way to grade 12. So we hope you enjoy Pacifica. Thank you. ladies and gentlemen, thank you so much for a wonderful evening of music. We really appreciate your support over this program. We most certainly will be back in the summertime. Don't forget the August 17th. August 17th, put it inside your calendar. That is the parent preview for next year's marching band season, and we would love to see you out there. Thank you so much, everybody. Have a wonderful rest of your school year and drive home safely. Don't forget that Four Boys is doing a fundraiser for us. Also, Manja is doing one tonight. So please go head over there and go get some cookies and cream ice cream, because that's the best at Four Boys. Thank you so much, ladies and gentlemen. Have a great night.